Greetings and welcome to another episode in the Full Clear series of Xenoblade Chronicles X. I am Jeff the Christian Gamer, and we're going to be doing the mission, well, Chapter 11. So we're progressing through the game a little bit further here, so we can both obtain more... it's called consequences. So we can both obtain more storage probes and get closer to our Ares 9.
So, what should I whip up today?
Commander?
It's Lau. Hey, get away from that! Elma, get your butts over here!
What was that all about? Did I hear him talking to Lau?
Whatever it was, it didn't sound very good. We'd better get to the hangar ASAP.
Here we go again. Lau and his treachery. Jumping down to the hangar entrance.
Boy, have you lost your mind? You know damn well what that data means to us, to our entire race!
Of course I do. It means an end to this giant lie. I've been waiting a long time for this.
Commander, what's going on?
Ask Lau. We caught him stealing a data terminal with classified intel.
Stealing intel?
Explain yourself, Lau.
You should have let me die that day, Elma. You knew the truth. That I was a Ganglion spy.
What?
I had my suspicions. But I didn't want to believe it.
Your mistake. It'll cost you. The data and your newest skell, the Prog Ares. The Ganglion will appreciate the gift.
Boy, I am gonna kick your ass so hard, your real body will feel it.
Not if you value your precious data.
Mom! What the hell's going on here?
Oh, look at this. The whole gang's coming out to say goodbye.
What the hell, Lau?
Hold your fire! He's got the only copy of that data on his mem.
Damn it.
A little insurance policy. Sorry, Doug.
You'd betray all your friends? Your entire species?
Well, I'm no big fan of theirs, believe me. The talking cats or that giant leech. But the Ganglion and I share a common goal.
And that is...
Think about it, Doug. You know the answer.
The hell I do! You've lost
it. Yeah. I lost it all. Goodbye.
Lau!
this guy.
All right, what exactly happened back there?
Welp, you all know how Frontier Nav uses the White Whale's trajectory data to simulate potential crash scenarios, then cross-checks it with our probes to narrow down possible lifehold coordinates. Well, all that work paid off. We finally got enough probes in the ground to accomplish what we've been trying to do. In other words, we can isolate every possible landing zone and scan them to find the lifehold core.
What?
Oh!
Are you certain?
That's what the eggheads tell me.
Tatsudu, dance of discovery!
So what are we waiting for? Lao? I don't get it.
I think I do.
That's right. He took the terminal that was analyzing the data and deleted all the backups for good measure. We already started over. But the coordinates were calculated from a massive amount of accumulated data. Redoing all the work we did up until this point could take weeks. If not more.
Which means the life hold would run out of time first, and then... poof.
Bingo.
Then we have no choice.
We have to find Lao and recover that terminal.
For now, let's assume he's headed for that Ganglion stronghold we heard about north of Silvalum. We'll need to hurry.
I just hope that Gajarg guy was telling the truth.
Everything is riding on this mission. Don't screw it up. That goddamn good-for-nothing guy. What the hell is he after?
Off to call Dros. Specifically, the Orsem Gate.
Reading. It's the Prague Ares. This puts its signature in the middle of the large chamber on the other side of this structure.
You think we found Lao then?
He can't be far. Let's go.
Okay. I have no idea how to open this.
All right. Let's look around and see if we spot another entrance.
And how about door up over there?
Okay. Back to my class of choice here. Look at my skills. Gonna scroll through and show you guys what skills I have, because it would take a good little while to explain why I have these skills. Just know they are the best based on what I could find so far. Let's go ahead and look at our arts. Chose this for both damage output and rigidity. See how well it works out. This is my current favorite class.
Very well. Engaging. Lay down the fire skin. We appreciate the help. Rising shadow strike. Furious blast. Nice. Ready? Too bad. Now, aim for the toppled enemy.
Bombardier.
Now, melee attacks. Absorbers. Ready? Too bad.
Turn around? Walk away, maybe? No?
Fine. Move in!
Going.
Yeah. work like a charm.
First grenade!
Shine blast!
Appreciate it.
Upper hand!
Okay. That's fine. Hello. He goes. Mistaken. Pick up this item. See where this elevator goes. almost anti-climax. Benefits of over-leveling. Some stuff just doesn't mess with you.
Come on, you and me.
Except for this guy.
Power dive! Take the initiative! Close it! Accepted even if I wanted it, though.
Here comes another probably battle. Oh. Dude, I fight you guys all the time.
The clock's ticking. Take it down quickly.
What do you think it is?
Part of a machine?
Silly friends, it obviously keyed to big door from before.
I actually think he's right.
Okay. Wow. This way we can ride our skells in.
Exactly.
Expected no less from NLA's number one team.
Lau!
Lau!
Ganglion really are afraid, you know. Even Luxar, their leader, trembles at the idea we might get our bodies back. That's why he had me stick around here, to keep you out of his tendrils.
You knew we had no choice. We had to chase after that stolen data terminal.
None of this will matter soon. Once they destroy the Lifehold core and all of us with it, this'll all be over.
You don't sound so excited anymore.
Of course I'm excited. Why wouldn't I be? We can finally stop living this goddamn lie. We'll all be free at last.
We'll all be dead, Lau. How does that free anyone? Instead of reuniting with our real flesh and blood?
Wrong. We're already dead, Lau. Our flesh and blood burned away with the earth.
Listen, Lau. We don't have time for a debate here. We came here for that terminal, and we're taking it back with us, whether you like it or not.
Of course. You wouldn't want to hear this, would you? Or have them hear it? Fair enough.
Get wrecked.
Take the initiative. Close in. One slope. Empty in all sections.
Take this. Nice job. We're just getting started.
This is wrong. Humanity should have died out along with the Earth. We should have let nature take its course and accepted our fate.
You don't believe that, Lau. If you did, you would have never volunteered to work on Project Exodus in the first place. Or on the White Whale's crew!
Well, I was a believer once. I honestly thought we could pull it off. I knew we couldn't save everyone, of course. Billions of people in that time frame? But a cross-section of races? Religions? Yes, it felt like all the usual politics disappeared. People from different countries had to come together. There was no other choice! This was survival! So I signed up.
So what happened?
It was all lies. If you weren't rich, or connected, or part of the First World Elite, you got left to die on Earth.
What?
Oh, yes. The only reason people like you and me got on board the White Whale is because they could use our skills, exploit our talents. But everyone else? All those countless souls boxed up in your precious Lifehold core? The same elitist bastards that decided they're the only part of humanity worth saving.
No.
If you don't believe me, ask Elma.
I can't say I agreed with how all the passengers were chosen. But I hardly see how it justifies this madness. We were acting to save the human race. I never understood why humans separate themselves off. Race, by class, religion, country, age, as if it matters in the end. On a genetic level, the differences are insignificant.
No, not insignificant. Not to humans, but really, how could you understand, Elma? Sorry, but I won't let those bastards purge what made us human. They'll kill us all first.
Wow, look. I admit I had no idea about any of this, but killing what's left of us isn't going to solve anything. It's you playing God instead of them. How is that fair?
Don't talk to me about fair. Is it fair what happened to my wife and little girl?
Oh.
That's why I volunteered. I didn't sign up for Project Exodus because I wanted to save the human race. I signed up for Project Exodus because I wanted to save my family. We knew there were no guarantees we'd be chosen, of course. We promised each other we'd accept our fate either way. But at least, this way, we had a chance. We had something to hope for. Hope was all we asked for. But there was never any hope. Not really. The decision was already made. We just didn't know it yet. These scum deserve to die, Elma!
No one deserves to die, Lao.
Tell that to Charmaine. And Chenxi. Tell it to everyone we left back on Earth. And you knew. You knew they'd seal the fate of all those people. And then you lied. You lied about why no one could know who made it onto this ship until after launch.
The decision came down to saving a subset of humanity or total extinction. I stand by that decision. And I'd do it again. Enough talk. I don't expect you to agree with every decision that was made in the past. But I won't let you destroy humanity's future.
Fair enough. I don't expect you to agree either. But that won't stop me!
No more fighting, Lao, and no more excuses. The data.
Go ahead, Elma. Go ahead and shoot, if you're so sure of yourself. Just don't hit the terminal. So, what's it gonna be? The chest or the head? You've got a 50-50 chance. And the fate of all humanity hanging in the balance. Gotta love those odds. So, what are you waiting for?
No, Elma! Not like this!
Step aside, Lin. If I can shut down his mem, there's still a good chance we can extract the data afterwards.
No, damn it! That's not even the point! We're all on the same side here!
You too?
Thank you. Elma, listen. I understand Lao's anger. I lost my family to an accident a long time ago. But if someone promised me a chance of saving them, and that was all a self-serving lie, who knows what I would do?
Lindy.
It's disturbing, and corrupt, and disgusting, and yet, that's exactly what makes us human. Maybe we really should have been wiped out of existence. But then...
abandoning my little crusade. Guess I'm just as corrupt as anyone else.
Lao.
I changed my mind.
Changed your mind?
I thought this was about them, but somewhere along the way, it became about me.
and about revenge.
It's over now.
So go. The Lifehold Corps has built in auto defenses. It'll take them some time to destroy it. If you hurry, you might still make it in time.
He's right. There's no time to lose. Lynn, can you finish the analysis here?
It's technically possible, but without the full NLA mainframe working on it, it would take way too much time.
Then we have no choice. Let's get back to the city ASAP.
Lao Tu, come back with us to New LA.
Yeah, right. As if I could ever set foot inside that city again.
It won't be like that. Not once everyone knows the facts, at least. They might not agree, but they will understand.
You're naive, Lynn. They lock me up and toss away the key. Or worse, a lot worse.
Maybe, but that's on you. You have a lot to answer to. So either way, we're taking you back with us.
I'd rather be shot.
Come on, Lao. Let's go home.
Fine, whatever. But there's no time to evac me. You go ahead.
But that's... Elma.
He's right, Lynn. Time is running out. We need to move. And fast.
All right, then. Lao, we'll send some medics for you, okay? Just stay put. Until then, you're not allowed to die, you hear me? I'll see you back in New LA.
Sure. Great, you got it. Now would you go already?
Okay.
Tatsu will split special lunchbox with Lao. Because Lindley says Lao not allowed to die. So Lao stay alive for Lindley or else Tatsu kill him.
Up in a new mem anyway. Charmaine, Chenxi, I'm so sorry, girls. It seems like Papa can't come to be with you just yet. Damn it. I'm sorry. You watch over each other until I get there.
Tell me you got it.
Yes, sir.
Thank God. Let's get it analyzed.
Commander, hold on. Lao's still back at the Ganglion base in Caldros. He's seriously injured.
Yeah? And? What exactly are you getting at? I know you aren't suggesting we help that backstabbing bastard. He tried to kill you guys.
I am, but...
He's been through a lot, Commander. You know his story as well as anyone. When we signed off on Project Exodus, we knew there'd be cases like Lao. Potentially hundreds of them. Look at Irina. She's still struggling with losing her brother. But we moved forward anyway, for the greater good of mankind.
Irina didn't try to kill us. In fact, she's been doing everything she can to help further Blade's cause.
Are you sure?
According to Gwyn, she's been acting strange, reckless, almost suicidal. He thinks maybe she wants to die.
It takes different forms, but it's coming from the same place as Lao. Of course, it's no excuse for what he's done, just putting it in perspective.
Fine. We'll bring him in.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, Commander.
I wouldn't get too excited about it. Especially after I break every bone in his body.
It's going to take a bit to complete the analysis. Let's regroup at the barracks.
And there it is. We have completed Chapter 11. Man. Yeah, that was a heavy one. The morality of the actions of a few. Very classic, very theme. One that I actually admire probably the most about anything else. The most over anything else in this game. At any rate, thank you guys for watching. If you liked the video, please subscribe and or click that like button. I am Jeff the Christian Gamer, and I'll catch you guys next time.